Okay, then this is where we left you. The impulse pathway. المسار بتاع النبضة العصبية اللي نشأت جوه النيورون. It's important to relate some facts at the beginning. The pathways from the sensory receptors to the cortex ومن الكورتكس للمسلز cross over. يعني ايه؟ يعني whatever you see with your right eye projects to the left part of your brain and whatever will move your right hand will be controlled by the left part of your brain. So, movements of the right side of the body are controlled by the left side of the cortex and vice versa. وده لو كان بنتكلم على movement اللي هي motor activity. لو هنتكلم على sensory info أو input زي sound مثلا, the sound that you hear with your left ear will mainly reach the right side of your cortex. This does not mean that the two halves of the brain work independently. بالعكس, the two halves of the brain are connected, as we said at the very beginning of the lecture, through a bundle of fibers that we called at the time the corpus callosum. ده لوحده كفيل ان هو يسينرجايز او يكونكت both lobes together. طيب, how is an impulse generated? لما النيورونز بتستقبل أو بترسل رسائل, they transmit electrical impulses along their axons, which are the long cord-like processes, which can range in length from a tiny centimeter to about 1 meter or even 1.5 meter, the طول الأكسون. Imagine how long, قد إيه المسار الطويل على النبضة العصبية إنها تمشي فيه. Nerve impulses involve the opening and closing of ion channels. It's now becoming complicated a bit. And I think here is where we have to show a drawing. And we will translate each and every word into a diagram. Nerve impulses involve the opening and closure of ion channels. This is an ion channel. These are, what are these? These are the ion channels. These are selectively permeable. بمعنى انها بتمرر حاجات وبتمنع حاجات. Selectively. Selectively permeable. Water filled molecular tunnels. يعني عبارة عن انفاق او اماكن للمرور مليانة بالمية. Water filled. و selectively permeable بتسمح بمرور اشياء واشياء اخرى تمنعها. Through the cell membrane, and this complex structure that you see with the blue heads من هنا ومن هنا, this is the structure of your cell membrane. So through the cell membrane وعلى مسافات, you will find these structures which are called the ion channels that are as I am repeating again, water filled selectively permeable channels. All right. These allow ions, and Bardo, to remind you, ions are electrically charged atoms, and will also allow small molecules to enter or leave. And the drawing explains everything. These small orange-like structures are ions, electrically active molecules. All right, these pass through the water-filled selectively permeable ion channels that are present within the structure of a cell membrane. وعلى الجانب الآخر, you can see how easily these green spheres can pass without the need for any selectively permeable channel or otherwise. Why? Because simply whatever these structures are made up of is lipid, which is fat. Fat passes easily through fat, and your cell membrane is made up of fat. The problem happens when you have ions and water-soluble structures that are supposed now to pass through the cell membrane. You have then to have such a structure, and this structure is called the ion channel. So, to recapitulate again, nerve impulses will involve to be formed the opening and closure of ion channels. which are selectively permeable, water-filled molecular tunnels that pass through the cell membrane and allow ions, which are electrically charged atoms or small molecules, to enter or leave the cell. The flow of ions itself, المرور في حد ذاته, will create an electric current. This will create very, very tiny voltage changes across a neuron's cell membrane. So the ability of a neuron أو قابلية الخلايا العصبية لتوليد electrical impulse or to generate an electrical impulse will depend on the difference in charge على الجانبي cell membrane inside and outside the cell membrane. هي دي الخلايا العصبية. This is part of its axon. What happens is in the resting state من غير أي action بيبقى the inside of the cell membrane of a neuron is negatively charged as you see here and the outside is positively charged. مع دخول الايونز هيحصل ان جوه يبقى فيه positive charges وتطلع negative charges الى الداخل. مع دخول انهي ايونز؟ The sodium ions in particular. This increases positivity inwards. الchange اللي حصل ده اسمه action potential. So an action potential is generated as sodium ions flow inwards across the cell membrane في مكان معين at one location. ثم what happens next is in المكان اللي حصل له depolarization ده للaction potential spreads بينتقل إلى المكان المجاور. مع دخول صوديوم في المكان المجاور to the neighboring region of the membrane re-initiating action potential دلوقتي في مكان جديد. المكان اللي لسه حالا كان حاصل فيه activity بيبتدي ترجع له negative charges في الداخل من تاني and this is what you call repolarization. يبقى حصل depolarization مع دخول الصوديوم وجوه بقى positive وبره بقى negative. مع انتقال الويف دي يرجع البوتاسيوم دلوقتي يدخل ويبقى فيه او يخرج اسفه ويبقى فيه negative charges inside. This is what you call reversal of polarity or repolarization. وبكده هتنتقل النبضة العصبية في اتجاه واحد مع repolarization to the left and depolarization to the right. بيبتدي الكلام ده يتحرك and this is what you get propagating nerve impulse أو انتقال سلمي للنبضة العصبية. When a nerve impulse begins, a dramatic reversal in the electric potential occurs on the cell membrane. As the neuron switches from a resting state بتاعتها اللي هي internal negative charge to a positive charge state. ادي تاني. What happens now? The action potential ده مع the opening of an ion channel. In response to a signal, the cell body دلوقتي اللي هو اسمه السوما becomes depolarized. يعني هيدخل له صوديوم وبالتالي the charges on the inside aspect of the cell membrane will become positive and this is what you call depolarization. هنا نشأ an action potential. This depolarization will now spread down the axon. In the meantime, وفي خلال نفس الوقت, the first part that was depolarized هيبتدي يحصل له repolarization, بمعنى هيرجع للresting state تاني. Because sodium channels are simply inactivated, مش هتقدر تشتغل أكتر من كده. وكمان, additional potassium channels will now open. And the membrane cannot depolarize again. وبالتالي النبضة مش هترجع للخلف تاني وحتستمر في اتجاه معين من ال cell body to the nerve terminals حيث تكون هنا مثلا muscle أو whatever the target structure is. ده يكفل انتقال ال electrical impulse in one direction only. The action potential اللي هنا in green will continue to travel down the axon as you see in one single steady direction. Amazing and marvelous. The change that you call action potential will pass, as we said, along the axon's membrane and speeds up to several hundred miles per hour. سرعة انتقال النبضة العصبية amounts to several hundred miles per hour. وبهذا, in this way, a neuron may be able to fire impulses multiple times every single second. وهو ده بالظبط المطلوب when reflex action is your target. علشان تسحب ايدك من حاجة لسعتك او وجعتك you need to act very fast, and to do this you really need a rate of electrical transmission that is several hundred miles per hour or even more. When these voltage channels reach the end of an axon, they trigger the release of what you call the neurotransmitters, وهي دي ال chemical messengers of the brain. تاني, again, this is the cell body, this is the axon, and these are the axon terminals, اللي هي في حالة اتصال مع another neuron. This neuron is called presynaptic, and this one is called postsynaptic, and the meeting together happens at what you call a space, that is the synaptic gap or synaptic cleft. مع ال wave of action potential, يعني depolarization, followed by repolarization and again depolarization, 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 and so on, the impulse reaches the new cell, the postsynaptic cell. What happens in this area, لو عملنا لها تكبير أو عملنا لها magnification, لو كانت هي دي ال presynaptic cell وتحت هو ال postsynaptic cell, so what happens is مع وصول ال action potential, you will find هنا في محتويات ال terminals بتاعت ال axon في what you call vesicles. هذه ال vesicles أو هذه الحويصلات بتحتوي على chemicals inside them, vesicles containing neurotransmitters أو الموصلات العصبية. Now what happens is in مع وصول ال action potential, these vesicles will now unite with the membrane هنا وحتفتح مطلقة ما تحتمل ما تحمله من ال neurotransmitters to the gap, الجاب أو الكليفت. الجاب أو الكليفت هنا بتنتهي ببداية ال postsynaptic cell اللي بتحمل مستقبلات أو receptor sites لهذه ال neurotransmitters, وهكذا تضمن انتقال الخلايا العصبية أو ال nerve impulse not just from one part of the same axon to the next, لا, from one neuron to the next, from the pre to the post synaptic neuron. This is how electrical transmission takes place. فالneurotransmitters, which are the chemical messengers in the nervous system, are released at nerve terminals, as we said. They diffuse across the synaptic cleft and they bind to receptors on the surface of the target cell. هذه target cell غالبا ما تكون another neuron, ساعتها هتسميها postsynaptic neuron, إنما في أحيان أخرى كثيرة برضو ممكن ينتهي النerve بالaxon terminals بتاعته في muscle, وهكذا يحدث ال contraction of the muscle, أو في gland, وهكذا يحدث وصول أمر ال secretion أو الإفراز لهذه الغدة أو ال gland. الريسبتورز اللي كانت موجودة في الصورة هنا على السطح بتاع ال postsynaptic cell أو على سطح المسل أو على سطح الجلاند أو whatever is next to the synaptic place هي اللي هت take up ال neurotransmitter material itself, وعليه هيحدث يا إما on أو off switch للخلية التالية. Again I'm repeating, تطلع خلية عصبية postsynaptic أو تطلع muscle أو تطلع gland. It will switch it either on or off, to start or to stop secretion, to start or to stop contraction, to start or to stop transmission of the electrical impulses. يبقى عندما يصل ال transmitter لل place that it should reach, ال interaction ده هيغير في ال target cell membrane potential again, and will trigger a response. A response ده زي ما قلنا يطلع contraction of a muscle, يطلع stimulation of enzyme activity, يطلع generation of a new action potential in a postsynaptic neuron. This is the basics. These are the basics of how the nervous system is made up of and the different parts of the brain, why we in particular as humans have the most complex brains ever, subhanallah, and how structure relates to function. وفي الآخر we gave a small hint on how a nerve impulse is generated, مفهوم عام, general concept لل الاكشن بوتنشال اند ذا بروباجيشن اوف ذا اكشن بوتنشال اند ذا سينابتيك ترانسميشن ونهايات السينابس اللي في الاخر هتكفل ليك اكشن معين بيحدث او بيبقى executed او ينفذ اللي هو زي ما قلنا يا اما a muscle to contract يا اما a gland to secrete يا اما a new action potential to be generated. Thank you very much.